chairman and the UPND have come with many promises, and we have a duty to protect Zambians by ensuring that Mr. HNM and the UPND deliver each one of those promises they made to the Zambian people. We must ensure that they deliver free education from preschool to university. And now that the schools are opened, I want to urge all parents in the Republic of Zambia to basically just prepare groceries and supplies, because school fees are all sorted out now that we have Mr. HLM as president. Further to which, I urge all students and pupils from universities and colleges and all the schools to be able to call on us who are ready to march with them to petition and picket the new government to ensure that free education as promised is delivered. It's time to create fundamental economic mistakes. It's not time to create fundamental economic mistakes on a trial and error manner. And on this one, I want to challenge the new president, President Kay Felix. He has announced on Facebook that he has appointed a team of economics, or a team to look at the mining tax or the tax regime, so that they can correct, according to him, the mismanagement of the economy. Mr. Kay Felix, President of the Republic of Zambia, you are no longer a private citizen. You are President of the Republic of Zambia. Whatever you do, you are expected to account to the Zambian people. You can't tell us that you have appointed a team without naming who is in the team, because we are suspicious. When I look through my binoculars, which I'm going to launch very soon, I am seeing foreigners. I am seeing all these Western countries. They are the ones surrounding him to advise him on the route to take, because they want to take advantage of his being new, not understanding many things, so that they can drive their economic agenda to continue cannibalizing our resources. Who are these people that he has appointed? Colleagues, let's open our eyes. Last, we want to say, no Zambian should be left vulnerable. Mr. President, Kay Felix has promised a many of things, and we will ensure that they happen. If at all he is any close to being an honorable man. Number one, he promised free education, isn't it?
Yes.
He promised free education, isn't it?
Yes.
So, free education it is, and free education now. He promised jobs for all youths in Zambia, whether educated or not, isn't that so?
Yes.
And those jobs must come when? And we have seen a video of one of the spokespersons, because in UPND there are 60 spokespersons. So there is one spokesperson in the name of Edgar Ngoma, who has told us that in Nimba alone, they will have an airport, they will employ 5 million youths. We are waiting. He promised to increase by 1,500 kwacha to all civil servants across the board. Isn't that what he promised?
Yes.
So that increment must come now. He promised to restore bursaries and meal allowances to all students and scrap off the loan scheme from all universities in the country. Isn't that what he promised?
Yes.
He said that it's free education, isn't it?
Yes.
So, free education indeed. He promised a fertilizer to farmers will be sold at 250 kwacha. Isn't that what he promised?
Yes.
And now we're getting into the farming season, isn't it? Therefore, farmers must brace themselves to go and buy fertilizer at 250 pounds. He promised employment for all qualified nurses, doctors, teachers, and the entire 25,000 in the next 100 days. Isn't that what you promised?
Yes.
We want that instead of employing the 25 at a go, at least let employ just 1,000 in this week, so that we see that he has started dismantling the 25,000. He promised jobs for all cadres in bus stops and markets with proper wages and salaries. Isn't that what he promised?
Yes.
So all those who have been chased from the markets, those who have been chased from the bus stops, please begin to line up. Jobs are coming with good salaries. He promised 3 meals for all in Zambia. Lastly, colleagues, I want to address something that is of great concern to me. I happen to have been among those that accompanied His Excellency Dr. Edgar Tagwanomu to the inauguration. He needed not to even attend. He had already conceded and allowed that a new president will take over. But as a way of keeping with the credentials of the Republic of Zambia, he chose to go to the inauguration. Apparently, that inauguration was basically a political rally for the UPND. Ms. Aka, in the one vein, he was saying, I don't want cadres, before he knows, his nose, where cadres, who even began to determine where dignitaries and leaders should sit. And according to the script of UPND, former ministers and an entourage of a former president needed to be ushered in the holding room to watch the proceedings at the same premises where the proceedings are taking place from the holding room. And Zambians are celebrating, not knowing that in celebrating you are fertilizing a wrong precedent. Next time there will be a new government forming. Ms. Aka, because of the way President Edgar Lungu was treated at Hero Stadium, I do not see my brother agreeing to go to an inauguration for a new president in 2016, which I believe will happen, to be subjected to that kind of behavior. That must be condemned by well-meaning Zambians. I've heard my brother keep on mentioning and complaining, referring to his time that was incarcerated for 100 and something days. I want to advise President Hakainde Hichilema that he must release himself from prison, like Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela, when he spent 27 years in prison, under the apartheid regime, and after doing that time, they were even using the bucket system. You have to use your bucket to help yourself and all that. It was humiliating. When he left prison in after 27 years, after he was asked, he said to the world that I made a moral and conscious decision to leave prison and everything about that prison in prison. And therefore, he replaced bitterness with love. He replaced vengeance with reconciliation. And therefore, he had a clean and free conscience as he continued to execute his duties as President of the Republic of South Africa. That's why those same people were oppressing him under the apartheid regime, including police officers, soldiers. Some of them became top officials on his security team. And as I come yesterday, I cautioned my brother, don't distance yourself from security agencies, the defense force, and leading to them to think that your cadres around you will protect you. Now we are hearing that he's even refusing to move from his private property. He wants it gazetted so that he doesn't stay in state house. That is outright plunder of natural resources. Because then the government will be compelled to try and convert the so-called community house into a well-facilitated, equipped residence for a president. Let's not joke about these things. And then he's not going to be president for life. It may be 5 years. So you spend a lot of money on his private residence. What happens when he loses in 2016? How will the government recover from the expense that will be incurred in equipping that particular problem? Two, where his house is in Forest 27 or is it Forest 26, it is remote away from other facilities that are necessary to make sure that a Republican president is well secured. So the positioning of State House was also for a purpose. Of course, we can't say details, but you can guess one. So it's not about wanting to live in a mansion. You are now public property, and you are expected to be looked after by the public. Unless he was mistaken, he thought that he's buying for a position to be a permanent. He was buying to become a Republican president, and he must be looked after as a Republican president. He is a property of the Zambian people. Now, he may take offense in what I say. You know the way it is, eh? We have exchanged positions. Just a few weeks or few months ago, President Lungu and all of us were in cabinet. We were the servants of the people. UPND and the Zambian people were the bosses. That's why they were telling us all the things they were telling us. But actually, we now are the bosses. And we are saying to our number one servant, you can't stay in your house. You have to move to an institutional house, which is well equipped with all the necessary requisites for him to be protected. If anything happens to him, what is at stake is the sovereignty of the state. Let's not joke about those things. And whoever is patronizing him and telling him you can do what you want, where are the custodians of state machinery to move in and be able to tame our new president before he makes blunders that will cause us to cry tomorrow? We have said, I want to state that the journey in the governance of this country for the European Union will be characterized by proper checks and balances. That's why today I have come to announce to the Zambian people that the opposition voices, not only this one, but many that are rising, we are launching today what is called operational binoculars. Operational binoculars, it tells that we are going to be watching this government and their president very closely in their chamber, in the open place, in their secret conversations, to make sure that whatever they plan and meditate to do is in the interest of the public concern. So these binoculars are to watch UPND. And I can see that from where I'm standing, there is a list of officers in the police service that has been proposed that they be promoted. Some are constables, they want them to jump to become superintendents, and so on. But what is of concern is that that list only has names from Southern Province, from Western, and a few from Northwestern. And we say that this is not proper. And I think when I look again with this binoculars, I can see a list of those who have cases and are associated with UPND, who they want to clear quickly so that they can be free to be appointed in certain positions. But I also see another list of PF former ministers, and PF associates, and all those that they want to unleash their feet and all these people again, so that they can silence them, that list, that list. Okay, the names are some of them from Wakula, yeah, that one, yes. Some of them from Northern, yeah. I can see the one from Chinda, yeah, that one, yeah. So that list is being pursued. I think that's what we're going to be doing in the next 5 years. So to that effect, colleagues, operational binocracy is working on all the four corners of this country. There's nothing that the UPN will do that will be permitted that is against the interests of the Zambian people. We are ready to die for our democracy. We are ready to die for our sovereignty. We are ready to die to protect what was achieved in 1964. No American, no European, no imperialist will be allowed to capture state power through the back door to try and advance their continued cannibalization of our natural resources. So abash imperialism. Abash. Thank you very much.